The 1994 April annual town meeting was called to order at 8 p.m. on this 11th day of April 1994. At this time, we should have only registered voters in the meeting hall. People who are registered voters and have checked into the meeting as evidenced by a green badge. The only person who is not a registered voter whom the chair will allow to be here is the gentleman who's handling the TV camera and who will duly be voted in at the earliest possible opportunity. Before we proceed with the meeting, I'd like to call on the chairman of the Board of Selectmen to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. Mr. Washburn. Have any motions to admit visitors to the meeting? Mr. Washburn.
Mr. Moderator, I move that the following persons be admitted to the meeting. Sean Morley to have freedom of floor, Richard Porcelli to have freedom of floor, George Dow Sr., Robert Torres to have freedom of floor, Roger Young, David Putney, Steve Higgins, Kathleen Apigian, Dave Hanlon, and Rosalind Spielman.
You have heard the motion to admit visitors. Is there any discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye. Those opposed? Unanimous. Now, those unregistered voters who are employees of the town may be seated either with their respective boards at the tables in front or with their front row of the center section. Certain people have been granted freedom of the floor. They know who they are. Anybody else should be seated in the front three rows in the section to my right, which is the section to your left. Everywhere else, we should only have registered voters who have checked into the meeting as evidenced by a green badge. Last Thursday, we got as far as line item 103 under the education budget. We are left with one more item under the education budget, and that is item 104, Regional Vocational Technical School. Is there a motion under the Regional VOTEC? Mr. Sweeney. Please state your name and address, sir.
Paul Sweeney, 288 Park Street. I move to appropriate the sum of $108,102 to fund the Regional VOTEC budget as specified on line 104 as printed in the sponsor recommends column of the warrant.
You've heard the motion. Does the Finance Committee have a recommendation, Mrs. Vaca?
Yes, the Finance recommends.
Does the Board of Selectmen wish to make a recommendation? Mr. Washburn.
The Board of Selectmen recommends.
Is there any discussion, Mr. Sweeney? Oh. Any further discussion? Yeah, it's not. Okay, the motion is to appropriate the sum of $108,102 to fund the regional vocational technical budget. And we'll cut the motion off at that point because the rest is inconsistent. If that is all right with me, with you, Mr. Sweeney. The motion is for $108,102 to fund the regional VOTEC budget. Any further discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye. Those opposed? Unanimous. Thank you, Mr. Sweeney. We are now ready to draw the next item. Next item is finance. Which is on page 20 of the printed copy of the warrant. Mr. Daly. Mr. Daly, you have the floor.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Moderator, I move to appropriate the sum of $6,000 to fund the finance director budget as specified on line 12 as printed in the FinCom recommends column of the warrant.
You've heard the motion for $6,000. Does the Finance Committee have a recommendation?
Finance recommends.
Does the Board of Selectmen have a recommendation? Mr. Washburn.
The Board of Selectmen recommends.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Unanimous. Mr. Daly.
Mr. Moderator, I move to appropriate the sum of $106,034 to fund the accounting budget as specified on lines 13 and 14 as printed in the sponsor recommends column of the warrant along with the accompanying transfers.
You've heard the motion for line items 13 and 14. Does the Finance Committee have a recommendation, Mrs. Vaca?
Yes, the Finance recommends.
Does the Board of Selectmen have a recommendation, Mr. Washburn?
The Board of Selectmen recommends.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Unanimous. Mr. Daly.
Mr. Moderator, I move to appropriate the sum of $118,926 to fund the assessing budget as specified on lines 15 and 16 as printed in the sponsor recommends column of the warrant.
You've heard the motion. Does the Finance Committee have a recommendation, Mrs. Vaca?
Finance recommends.
Does the Board of Selectmen have a recommendation, Mr. Washburn?
The Board of Selectmen recommends.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Unanimous. Mr. Daly.
Mr. Moderator, I move to appropriate the sum of $63,326 to fund the Treasury budget as specified on line 17 and 18 as printed in the sponsor recommends column of the warrant.
You've heard the motion. Does the Finance Committee have a recommendation, Mrs. Vaca?
Yes, Finance recommends.
Does the Board of Selectmen have a recommendation, Mr. Bellino?
Yes, Board of Selectmen recommend.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Unanimous. Mr. Daly.
Mr. Moderator, I move to appropriate the sum of $160,354 to fund the collection budget as specified on lines 19 and 20 as printed in the sponsor recommends column of the warrant along with the accompanying transfers.
You've heard the motion. Does the Finance Committee have a recommendation, Mrs. Vaca?
Finance recommends.
Does the Board of Selectmen have a recommendation, Mr. Bellino?
Board of Selectmen recommends.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Unanimous. Mr. Daly.
Mr. Moderator, I move to appropriate the sum of $68,400 to fund the Information Systems budget as specified on lines 21 and 22 as printed in the sponsor recommends column of the warrant along with the accompanying transfers.
You've heard the motion. Does the Finance Committee have a recommendation? Mrs. Vaca.
Finance recommends.
Does the Board of Selectmen wish to make a recommendation? Mr. Washburn.
The Board of Selectmen recommends.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none. Mr. Sylvia. Microphone doesn't seem to be on.
I'd just like to get a little bit more detail about that particular item, if I could. $68,000 for expenses.
Mr. Daly, can you answer Mr. Sylvia's question?
Yes, I can give you some information on that right now, Mr. Sylvia. The information systems element of the finance division's budget is all expenses. There's no direct labor cost involved in that budget. However, we do use 2 to 3 people to maintain our computer networks, to troubleshoot our software and hardware problems, and we pay them as outside contractors so that there aren't any benefits costs associated with them. There's $59,000 in contracted services as part of that budget, along with, it's $61,000 in contracted services, and then another $7,000 in other costs, which pertain to the occasional replacement of hardware and troubleshooting on the software. Primarily, the $61,000 that has to do with contracted services is for the contracted people that we use, as I described earlier, but there's also a piece of that that goes for the maintenance of our software that we have purchased from a software vendor in Western Massachusetts for accounting purposes, and there's a piece in there for the maintenance of the assessing software that we use as well.
Any further discussion? Mr. Sylvia, you have a quick follow-up question.
It just seems to me that I see a lot of high numbers here, and this must be very delicate hardware that we're buying, and the software must be full of bugs and viruses. Holy Moses, that's a lot of money for a system that's established.
Any further discussion? Hearing none. On the motion, all those in favor, please say aye. Those opposed? Carried. Mr. Daly. Pensions and benefits, Mr. Daly.
Thank you, sir. I move to appropriate the sum of $2,227,204 to fund the pensions and benefits budget as specified on line 23 as printed in the Finance Committee recommends column of the warrant along with the accompanying transfers.
You've heard the motion. Does the Finance Committee have a recommendation? Mrs. Vaca.
Finance recommends.
Does the Board of Selectmen have a recommendation? Mr. Washburn.
The Board of Selectmen recommends.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Unanimous.
I'm sorry.
Mr. Washburn, for the purpose of a motion to admit.
Mr. Moderator, I move that the following person be admitted to the meeting, Richard Bowen.
You've heard the motion to admit Mr. Richard Bowen, Town Council, to